This is 7th standard science class and we are dealing with the chapter fiber to fabric. Children, in the previous class we just finished trying to know about different sources of animals which give us wool apart from sheep and goat. The regions are parts of our country where they are actually available, they are found, and different localities, their names and bit of some of the activities. Children, in this session, let us try to know how the wool giving animal, sheep, goat or any kind of animal which gives us wool can be taken care. That means rearing and breeding of sheep. Since sheep is the major animal which gives us the quantity, that is one of the important animal which gives us wool. Adds up to the quantity of the wool what is being used by the people, so it becomes very important for us to know how to take care of the sheep just to increase the production of the wool. So if we travel towards the hilly regions of Jammu and Kashmir, children, there are certain places given here in the textbook. That means Jammu, Kashmir, we have Himachal Pradesh, Uttaranchal, we have Arunachal Pradesh, Sikkim are also the parts of Haryana, Punjab, Rajasthan and Gujarat. In these places we see lots and lots of groups of shepherds taking their herds of sheep for grazing. That means we can know that these are the important parts of our India where sheep are reared and taken care. So sheep are found in these states and reared for the purpose of production of wool. One thing we understood where these sheep is found. Next comes the grazing, the food for the sheep. But the moment we say graze, children, it is nothing but the herbivorous. Of course, the sheep are herbivorous animals. They are fed with leaves and different parts of the plant as food, but whatever food is being given to these animals apart from the leaves of the plants, it has to be substituted with some other nutrients also for the well-being and for long life of these animals. Apart from the parts of the leaves, these animals are fed with pulses, corns, jowar and other types of oils also, which will be obtained from oil seeds, which will substitute with the different types of minerals apart from what it regularly eats. Seasonally talking, that means during the winter season where these animals cannot be taken out because of the cold climatic condition, they will be fed with grains and dry fodder. Means season wise also the food and the caring of these animals will be taken care by the shepherds with keen interest. That is one part, children. So apart from that, as in how I told you, in different states of our India we find this type of animal, and there is a small table given here in your textbook stating that what type of breed and what type of wool and in which state of our country this is available to us. We have different types of the breed. We actually learnt in the previous class saying that there are several breeds of sheep which are found in different parts of our country. So these are the different types of the breeds. We have Lohi, Rampur Bashir, Nali, Bakharwal, Marwari and Pathanwadi. And these are the types of wool that we get from this type of animals, breeds of these animals, and this in this column you have the places where these animals are found. That means this session, this class tells you what type of food is given for the sheep to be taken care, means to rear and care them, what type of food should be given, what are the different types of the breeds that are found in our India, and what are those wool called as, and where are they present. Apart from that, reproduction part of these animals also will become important. As discussed in the first class only, there are two different kinds of wool that we get. Only one type of wool we obtain from sheep is more beneficial to us. That means what we call as selective breeding. The animals are the sheep which is beneficial to us, which gives us a clean underskin fleece hair for the production of the wool. That type of breeds of sheep only has to be taken care. That only should be taken or selected for the breeding purpose. So we call that a selective breed. So we select at least one of the parent of the sheep will be of that species. So apart from the food, place where they are present, breeding process also matters for the production of the wool children. So only such type of sheep will be reared and they will be taken care. And once the reproduction part or the breeding part is also done, we will get a thick growth of hair on them, and that hair will be taken off or shaved off to get the fabric called wool. In the next class, children, let us see how the processing of fiber into wool will take place. Thank you all.